Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we're very lucky to have our regular guest, who is Matt from Collaboration Coach. Now Matt today is going to be diving into a few of the updates at Ignite 2019, which was one of Microsoft's software events. He will be going over what's going to be coming to Microsoft Teams in 2020, also talking about and talking you through a lot of the new features. So there are 8 features he's going to focus on. A big thank you to Matt. If you're watching this video, please make sure to subscribe to him. He has a fantastic channel which covers everything 365 and dives a lot into the Microsoft Teams line of products. So he is the expert you need to know. So guys, thank you very much to Matt. Let's dive into today's video.
Hello, it's Matt from Collaboration Coach. You may have heard that recently Microsoft held its Ignite conference, and at that conference there was a number of really exciting announcements for Microsoft Teams. So in this video, I thought I'd round up the best of the announcements and let you know what's new in Microsoft Teams. I've chosen 8 new features to talk about. I'm going to talk you through why I think they're cool and why you would use them. And at the end of the video, I'll let you know when they're available. This was just my pick. There are loads more, so I'll put a link in the description so you can check out the rest. And if you like videos on Microsoft Teams and Office 365 in general, then why don't you check out my YouTube channel, Collaboration Coach, where we're posting videos like that every week. My first pick is private channels. If you use Teams, you're probably aware that if you're an owner or a member of a team, you basically have access to everything. All teams are split up into channels, so you'll have access to all the channels. And what customers have been asking for a long time is to have private channels, so you can have a private space within your team. And private channels are now available in Microsoft Teams. You can create a private channel just like you would a normal one, and you can add the special permissions to it. And then it's only visible to those people that you've given the permissions to. My next pick is multi-window. Believe it or not, in Teams today, you have to do all your work within one window and you click around between your channels and Teams, but it's always in one window. So what's coming is support for multiple windows at the same time. If you wanted to have a chat and pop that chat out as another window, you could do that and allow yourself to switch between the existing windows and the chat. Same for meetings and channels and so on. So multi-window support will make your life a lot easier in using the Teams app. My third pick is messaging extensions. Often within a team meeting or just in general conversation, you want to ask people questions and get their feedback. So Microsoft are going to add what they call messaging extensions to Microsoft Teams. So when you're in a chat window, you'll be able to start a poll or a survey to ask people questions and get responses and feedback. And you'll be able to do this in the chat window and also in meetings, so you'll get real-time feedback during the meeting. Pinning has become pretty popular across all of Office 365. So you probably noticed that you can pin documents in Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. And Microsoft is adding the idea of pinning to Teams. So you'll be able to pin the teams that you care about and that you want to access quickly within the Teams app. It's just a productivity saver, so you don't have to go clicking around trying to find the team that you want access to. Microsoft also showed off some cool Outlook integration with Teams. So they're adding a share to Teams button. So if you receive an email message and you want to share it with your team, then you just hit the share to Teams button, choose the team you want to share with, and then it's done. Another integration with Outlook is the ability to reply to messages within Outlook. So when you receive a Teams email saying that someone's mentioned you or someone's made a comment, you can actually reply to that Teams conversation within Outlook. So you'll be able to type within the email, hit the reply button, and it will send your reply to Teams. Next is a feature that I know a lot of my customers are interested in, and that's tasks in Teams. So now you'll be able to access your to-do, Outlook, Planner, and Teams tasks all from one window within the Teams app. You'll be able to choose the view that works for you, like lists, boards, charts, and schedules. Pick number 7 is Microsoft Whiteboard integration. So this is dear to my heart because I'm a big fan of Whiteboard. I've done a few review videos over on my channel, and Microsoft Whiteboard integration with Teams means that During your meeting, you can fire up the whiteboard and you can make notes, and you can invite people to the whiteboard after the meeting as well. So you'll keep the whiteboard forever, so you can always refer back to it if you need to. And my last pick is live captions. So this means that as people are speaking in Teams meetings, it will caption their words in real time. So if you want to follow along by reading in a particular language, you can do that. So they're my 8 picks of what's new in Microsoft Teams. And just before we go, let's run through when they're available. Private channels are available now. Multi-window support will be coming in early 2020. Messaging extensions are coming at the end of 2019. PIN channels 2 at the end of this year. Outlook integration early 2020 alongside tasks in Teams. Whiteboard support is now available, and live captions should be here by the end of 2019. So that's it from me. Thank you so much for listening. It's always a pleasure to talk to the Keep Productive community. If you like this video and you want to see more, then head over to my YouTube channel, Collaboration Coach.